फ्रेंड्स, वी नो एनी बॉडी इज सब्जेक्टेड टू पुल और पुश टाइप फोर्स, देर इज चेंज इन डायमेंशंस ऑफ द बॉडी. लेट अस कंसिडर वन प्रिज्मेटिक बार और ए बॉडी हैविंग लेंथ यल, क्रॉस सेक्शनल एरिया से ए, क्रॉस सेक्शनल एरिया ऑफ द बॉडी इज ए, देन मॉड्यूलस ऑफ इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ दिस बॉडी इज कैपिटल ई. नाउ इफ दिस बॉडी इज सब्जेक्टेड टू एक्सियल पुल फोर्स, दैट इज पी. द बॉडी इज सब्जेक्टेड टू एक्सियल पुल फोर्स, दैट इज पी. नाउ ड्यू टू दिस फोर्स what will happen, the length of the body will increase by delta l. Now how to find this delta l, or how to find the change in length of a body due to force acting on it, or how to find out the elongation of this body due to force p, or how to find out extension, or how to find out elongation, or how to find out increase in length or decrease in length or contraction. So let us see how to find out delta L of this body. Now we know the formula for stress, that is sigma is equal to force divided by area, that is P is divided by A. Now we know this is for stress. We know for strain is equal to small e is equal to delta L divided by L. Delta L is a change in length divided by original length capital L. We know modulus of elasticity is the ratio of stress to the strain, is sigma divided by E. Now put the value of sigma here and value of E here. So capital E is equal to sigma is what, P divided by A, divided by small e is delta L divided by L. Now next step is this will goes on upper side, this will goes on down side. So E is equal to P divided by A into L divided by delta L. Now we require delta L. So delta L goes on this side, E goes on this side. So delta L is equal to P into L divided by A into E. This is the formula for change in the length of the body due to force acting on it, or elongation of body, or extension of body, or increase in length or decrease in length or contraction. Any word you can see in the examination. So this is the change in length of a body due to force acting on it. Here delta L is elongation or change in length or increase in length or decrease in length or contraction. P is a force acting on the body. L is a length of body, original length of body. A is area of a body. Now if this body is rectangular or square body, then area is B into D for rectangular body. If this body is circular, means diameter is there, then area is pi by 4 D square. And this E is a modulus of elasticity of a body in Newton per mm square. So If you have P, L, then area, modulus of elasticity, you can easily find out delta L or change in length of a body due to force acting on it. So this is a formula for change in length for this type of prismatic bar. Now see the bodies in series. So you may have this type of condition. This is a, if this is a body, This is a body having, suppose, three sections, 1, 2, 3. This is the body A, B, C, D. If the area of this AB section is A1 and modulus of elasticity for this section is E1. For this section, area E2, modulus of elasticity E2, A2, E2. For this section, area is A3, modulus of elasticity is E3. The area of this section is A3 and E3. Now, length of this, if the length of this section is L1, this section is L2, and this section is L3. Now, this is force, that is PA, that is force acting at section A. If this is force PB, if this is force PC, and if this is force PD. Now, due to this force system, the length of this body will change. Why this is called as bodies in series? Now, this is body 1, body 2, body 3, and all three bodies are in series. The axis of body is passing through the axis of individual body. Now, the first step to find out the change in length of this body is draw free body diagram. So this is the free body diagram. This is section AB, this is section BC, and this is section CD. Now, if this is P1, this is force P1. Now, this is, if this is P2, and if this is P3, this force is P3. So, this is L1, L2, L3, A1, A2, A3, E1, E2, E3, like this. Now, what is delta L1? Delta L1 is P1, L1 divided by A1, E1. We know for delta L, PL upon AE. For section 1, delta L1 is equal to P1 L1 divided by A1 E1. This is the change in length of section AB, that is section 1. This is 2, this is 3. For section 2, this is 2. So for section 2, P2 L2 divided by A2 E2. Here, take value of P2 is negative. Value of P2 as negative, because this is compressive load. For compressive load, take negative sign. For tensile load, take positive sign. For tensile load, there is increase in length. For compressive load, there will be decrease in length. So negative sign is there. Now for section 3, delta L3 is equal to P3 L3 divided by A3 E3. So this is the individual change in length of each section. Now what is net change in length or overall extension or total change in length of this body is in series, this composite body. So what is delta total L? Total delta L is equal to delta L1 plus delta L2 plus delta L3. So that is P1 L1 divided by A1 E1 plus P2 L2 divided by A2 E2 plus P3 L3 divided by A3 E3. This is the change in length of bodies in series. So this is also called as principle of superposition. Means this is change in length of section 1, this is change in length of section 2, this is change in length of section 3. What is principle of superposition? The total change or overall change is equal to the summation of change in length of individual section. This is the principle of superposition. According to principle of superposition, this is the formula for bodies in series, and this is the method to solve problem based on change in length of bodies in series. Dear friends, let us see what is mean by composite section or composite body. If this is the body, this is one bar, this is another one bar, and if this is third bar, and this is fixed, and if this is plate, one plate, and force P is applied here. Now this is section 1, this is body 2, this is body 3. Body 1, body 2, body 3. Maybe the material of all the bodies will be different, but the load P is, this is load P. Now what is load P? So load P is equal to, for composite body or composite section, load P is distributed on all the loads, that is P1 plus P2 plus P3. So P is equal to P1 plus P2 plus P3. If there are two bodies, then P1 plus P2. Now what is P? We know sigma is equal to P divided by A. So what is P? P is equal to sigma into A. So P is equal to sigma 1A1 plus sigma 2A2 plus sigma 3A3. So this is equation 1. And you can see, if the load applied at the center of this plate, the elongation of all the bodies will be same. The elongation or strain of all the bodies will same. मतलब आप यहाँ देख सकते हैं, यहाँ फोर्स अप्लाई किया है मैंने, तो यहाँ से जब मैं फोर्स अप्लाई करूँगा तो क्या होगा, मतलब बॉडी वन का, बॉडी टू का और बॉडी थ्री का इलोंगेशन सेम होगा, सेम इलोंगेशन होगा, मतलब स्ट्रेन सेम होगा. तो स्ट्रेन का फॉर्मूला क्या है, स्ट्रेन E1 इज इक्वल टू E2 इज इक्वल टू E3. स्ट्रेन इज सेम मींस इलोंगेशन इज सेम. सो व्हाट इज स्ट्रेन, स्ट्रेन यू नो E इज इक्वल टू सिग्मा बाय E. सो व्हाट इज E, सिग्मा डिवाइडेड बाय कैपिटल E. सो दिस इज सिग्मा 1 डिवाइडेड बाय E1 इज इक्वल टू सिग्मा 2 डिवाइडेड बाय E2 इज इक्वल टू sigma 3 divided by E3. This is equation 2. So use these two equations to solve the problems of composite sections. From this equation, you will get the value of sigma 1, sigma 2, sigma 3. This is the method to solve the problems of compound sections or composite sections. So this is all over about change in the length of bodies. So thank you very much.